What's up, everybody? Welcome to another video by DynamicalBlue43. Today, we'll be taking a look at Coriander Wide Track from the 2016 LA Speedway Series from Cars 1. I got this for my birthday. My birthday is on January 26, 2017, and my parents gave me this as a gift, and I want to thank my parents because if my parents did not give me Coriander Wide Track here, this video would cease to exist. So now let's get on to review of Coriander Wide Track here. Absolutely love her art. It is phenomenal art. She's looking up at the sky at the Jets, of course, and she is not there for the racer. She's there for the Jets. That's why she has a jet antenna of, I think, either Stubot the Jet for, Stubot the Jet or the other Jet. I forgot what his name was, but whatever. And also, the background for the series is all the LA Speedway, of course. You see some fans. And there's, of course, the Cardale Garage app. And we do not need to worry about that anymore, so I'll just not talk about that anymore in this video. And, of course, you can kind of see a little camera back there, if you can kind of see. And it looks like it says Cubby. I may be wrong, but probably does say that. Number one out of 11 in the series. On the back of the package, we see a nice picture of Marco Axmell and Fred. For some reason, neither of these two were actually released in the LA Speedway Series of 2016. Although Fred was released in the 2016 Rusty's Racing Series. And I feel like if they didn't make that series, then Fred would have been released in this series. And the Marco Axmell hasn't been released at all since 2010, unfortunately. So I feel like that would be an awesome release. Mattel decided not to put him in this series, nor the Piston Cup Series, because those were the only two series from 2016 that he could have fitted in. And then there's, of course, the description that is for the LA Speedway Series, and it reads, "The tiebreaker race at the LA International Speedway will determine who is the new Piston Cup champion." So let's take Coriander Wide Track out of the package. So here is Coriander Wide Track here out of her package. And now, as you can see, she has this very happy expression on her face. Of course, because she's looking up at the Jets. I love how they actually put her eyes looking up and not straight or forward or, like, you know, like to the right or left and looked it up, because that's how she was in the movie. So, yeah, good job on that, Mattel. And, of course, as you can see, she has this little jet thing right here because she is a fan of the Jets. She's not there for the races, but she is there for the Jets that fly over the stadium at the beginning of races before the races start. And I think this represents Stubot the Jet. I may be completely wrong right there. I can't remember the other Jet's name. I'm not entirely sure. If you guys remember his name, please let me know in the comment section down below. And, of course, she has these nice headlights, and she can kind of see her white teeth in there. And, of course, she is not a unibody, so that has been fantastic. I just put fabulous and fantastic together. And, anyway, she has purple rearview mirrors, and she has these silver rims, or tires, I guess you could say. And on the back, she has a license plate. Hopefully, my camera can focus in. There we go. It says 87E912. I can't read the text above it. I don't know what it says. So, unfortunately, I cannot read it. And the license plate is yellow, by the way. And also, she does have a black base with some information on it. And if you don't remember seeing her from the first Cars movie, she appeared at the LA Speedway, of course. Because if she didn't, she probably wouldn't be in the LA Speedway series. So, she, of course, appeared in the LA Speedway right after the Jets flew over the stadium. Of course, they lost Angeles International Speedway Stadium, and then they move on to three fans, being Coriander Wide Track here with her mom, Emma Breakdrum, on her right side. I'm doing it from Coriander's point of view, by the way. And, of course, Brake Boyd on her left side. And they are all like this, although Emma Breakdrum and Brake Boyd are both supposed to be looking up because they were looking up in the Jets in the movie as well. So that's inaccurate about those, but at least they did it right for Coriander. If you guys do not know, Coriander actually is not a new release. Her only two releases from previous in the Cars franchise was in 2010 as a single in the Final Lap Collection, and then she got a re-release in 2013 and a 7-car box set that included Kit Revster, Coriander Wide Track herself, Polly Puddle Jumper, Fiber Fuel, The King, King, McQueen, and Chick Hicks. And of course, she took a long break from then and then returned in 2016 for the LA Speedway series. So that was fantastic. And plus, I didn't have her from a previous release. Now, this is technically a new body for Coriander because her 2010 and 2013 release both had like this giant kind of model. It's kind of like MA Breakroom's here, although she was a little bit bigger than this, and that was completely inaccurate to the movie. They completely overscaled her, but they now downscaled her to the correct size, and I'm glad that they did that. I didn't think they would, but they actually did. So great job about that, Mattel. And she, of course, has flat eyelids with brown eyes. And I like to compare her to her mom and dad, of course, MA Breakdrum and Break Boyd. Now, do not ask me why their last names, I should say, are not the same. It's completely a mystery to me. I mean, I know these have to be a family because, of course, a child can go into the stadium on its own. And plus, when Break Boyd and MA Breakdrum here were named, they called them mom and dad. So yeah, I think it's kind of confirmed that they are her mom and dad, and they kind of have to be. And plus, if you think about it, red and blue makes purple, so it kind of makes sense. And here's a comparison between them. I think I already did it, but just in case, here it is. I'm gonna give him a 360 right here, and yeah, that's the comparison. And now Coriander is basically a smaller body style to her mom. They both have the same body style. And now, which one is your favorite? Tell me in the comment section down below. This is my question for this video. Which is your favorite between MA Breakdrum, Coriander Wydrak, and Break Boyd right here? I have to go with Coriander Wydrak just because he has this little jet accessory. And she's the only fan we've gotten so far that has this antenna accessory. And plus, she's accurate to the movie 100%. I don't think there's anything wrong about her. And now, before we end off this video, I like to compare the two cars that have a similar model to Coriander here. First, let's start off with Kim Carlins. I'll give him a 360. I think I reviewed Kim Carlins in my video. I mean, not video, in my channel before, quite a while ago. It was not, definitely not recent. But if I did, I'll leave a link in the description. But I don't think I know how to put links in the description to videos yet. So I don't even know why I said that. But if I did, you can look up Pixel Cars 2016 and maybe there, may not. Because I don't remember if I reviewed Kim Carlins and Dan Clarkenberg, but whatever. And these are the exact same model, but technically, Coriander is a different model because she needs the hole in like her hood part to attach the antenna. But generally speaking, they are the same model. Now let's compare to Marty Breakburst, another race fan, and they are the same. And she has a different model because she has this hole, obviously, to connect the jet. And now you might be thinking, well, Marty Breakburst has the hole too. But the thing is that from our point of view, it's not going to be from their point of view, but from our point of view, Marty Breakburst antenna little hole thing is on the right side, but Coriander's is on the left side. So that's why they're different models, but generally speaking, they are the same model. And here's a little 360 for them. And that pretty much does it for this video. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Stay tuned for more reviews coming soon. I'll see you guys by then. We're signing off.